just seems kind of dumb to keep talking about Cash App when you're not even sponsored.
I literally used my Cash App card today when I was getting some stuff from Target, and all I had to do was search for Target in the Cash App app, add it to my Cash App card, and then when I bought stuff from Target, I automatically got 5% off my order.
Five.
Now, if you order a lot of stuff from Target, well, most people, when you go to Target, you end up buying more stuff than you expect. It'd be nice to get some cash back, wouldn't it? And here's the cool thing. You can be double dipping, my friend, because Target already has this rewards program. You can sign up for that in the app, so you get rewards through the Target app. And then you can also use your Cash App card to get cash back there, too. I'm all about saving money. I don't know about you guys, but anyways, if you don't already have Cash App and or a Cash App card, use my link in the description. Get yourself some free cash. It'll also throw a little my way, you feel me? And you can customize your own Cash App card. I think it's dope. What we're going to be doing today is, because I've obviously mastered relationships and my marriage is the world's easiest, I'm going to be giving out some free relationship advice. Don't worry. It's all going to be some like super juicy stuff.
What do you mean by that?
You know what I mean. Enjoy the
Therapy.
Show.
Season 3 of Dara.
The title of the subreddit where this post comes from is called r/amiwrong. And guess what I'm going to be doing today?
I don't know, maybe some laundry, probably the dishes. You haven't cleaned up like your side of the bedroom in a
while. I'm going to be deciding whether the person posting is wrong or not.
Yeah, of course.
The title of this post is Mad at My Girlfriend for Sharing Location. I'm already against this person.
Am I, 20-year-old female, wrong for getting jealous/mad that my 21-year-old girlfriend has a million people's location? She shares her location on Find My iPhone with literally every friend she has, and I don't know why it bothers me. Recently, she started sharing her location with her coworkers, and I accidentally snapped when she told me. I usually keep my cool, but I just couldn't understand why she needed to do that. I can understand sharing location with siblings, family, close friends, etc., but she's only worked at this job since August and barely knows her coworkers. For extra context, she's pretty close to them, as they work all day together, 9 to 6 p.m., so I guess they could form a close bond given they spend so much time together. I just don't know if I'm crazy for being weird about this or not. Please let me know. Thank you.
I regret to inform you, but you are, in fact,
wrong.
I am a big fan of sharing your location with people that you care about or people that you're close to. I don't really see any downside to her coworkers knowing where she is. Now, my job, for example, I work at a couple of different spots depending on the day of the week. And my boss, who also happens to be my coworker and friend Sam, I share my location with her because I just get tired of us calling each other and texting each other and asking where the other person is. I just think it's more convenient if they know where I am. And it sounds like at this job, they're together all the time throughout the day. I don't know the specifics of this job that she works, but it might actually be beneficial if their job is anything like mine, where they might be in different locations. Why not have each other's location on? And I think just in general, it's good for the people close to you to know where you are. My wife and I share locations with each other. I encourage my sister and I to share each other's location, especially since she's going to college in Middle Tennessee, and I happen to be living in Middle Tennessee also. If anything were to ever happen to her, it would be nice to know the last place that she was, and vice versa, because like I trust her as an adult to, you know, want to know where I am too in the event that anything were to happen to me or if she needed me. I think my wife and her mom also share location with each other. I don't see anything wrong with it at all. I know that you said that when it comes to friends and family, you get it. But I could also see it being like a reasonable thing to do with your coworkers as well. Now, I do think if she is literally sharing her location with everybody and they're not even really that close, I could see how that could be an issue. Like if it's somebody that she meets out, like when she's just out with friends and they are just like mutual friends or whatever, it's like they don't need to know exactly where you live, especially if you and your girlfriend live together. Like, I don't want all these people knowing exactly when I'm home, when I'm not home, and exactly where I live. But I doubt that's the case. It sounds like it's only people that she's close with. But I don't know. I could understand wanting to draw the line somewhere. Like, for example, there's this feature on Snapchat called the Snap Map, and everybody that is your friend on Snapchat, they have the option to have their location on indefinitely in the Snap Map. So literally anybody they are friends with can see where they are at any given time, which is crazy. Like, I just remember when Spice and I lived together in Murfreesboro. Sometimes I would go home to Chattanooga to see my family. And on the Snap Map, you could see that she was in Murfreesboro at our apartment and I was in Chattanooga. So anybody that is friends with both of us on Snapchat would know that she was there and I was 2 hours away. And I don't feel like all of the people we're friends with on Snapchat need to know that like she's there by herself and I'm that far away. Like, so when it comes to things like that, I could understand like some of the trepidation, like the skepticism of having all of her friends know like when she's not at home. Like, I could see that being an issue. So I would definitely draw the line somewhere. But if it's just people that she works with and a couple of friends, it's not that deep. But I think you snapping at her is weird. Like, calm down, Turtle. Like, just have a normal conversation with her and explain why, like, it could potentially be dangerous. You being jealous should not be the concern. Like, it should be more of, like, a safety thing. This next segment is brought to you by r/relationship advice. And it's a little bit more intense than the previous bit, so just like strap yourself in.
So my 38-year-old husband spent $3,000 at
strip club?
And I, 38-year-old female, can't really get over it. He admitted everything to me, multiple lines off the stripper's tits in the VIP room, multiple lap dances, and throwing cash around. He was there for over five hours and ignored all my phone calls when I saw how much money was being spent. I didn't mind him going to the club, but private lap dances,
cocaine,
and $3,000 spent has left me feeling like he has cheated on me and betrayed me. He said he didn't touch them and they didn't touch him.
Okay.
I'm usually not a jealous person, but how do I move on from this?
Ladies, serious question. Is there a way to come back from this? Let's try and break this down bit by bit, okay? So this man spent $3,000 at a strip club. Like, I'm gonna go ahead and like give a full perspective of this from like both sides, okay? Like, I feel that like this is important. So would a man do this if he didn't feel like some part of him thought you would be okay with it? Let's start from the top, okay? He has $3,000 of disposable income to blow at the strip club.
Damn, son.
You know, so like, I feel like that's a positive. Like, the man must be making pretty good money. And I feel like him admitting everything to you is kind of his way of saying like, look, this is exactly what happened. I feel like we have this level of trust and honesty between each other.
You're actually justifying
you this? Don't seem like super bothered about like specifically about the fact that he was doing multiple lines of blow. Like, I think it's weird that there isn't context provided as far as, was this a bachelor party? Was this a vacation? Did he like win a trip or something? Did you owe him this? Like, so him being there for 5 hours is like very sus. Like, I feel like that's something worth kind of highlighting. Him ignoring phone calls is like not the best, but like, also, what are you gonna pick up the phone and say in the midst of this? I think it's actually better that he didn't pick up the phone. And I think this is an important bit also. Quote unquote, when I saw how much money was being spent. So I guess you both have access to the funds that are coming out of this account. So I feel like he knows that you're going to see this, you know? And this is also important. She says, I didn't mind him going to the strip club, but private lap dances, cocaine, and $3,000 spent. That's got me feeling like he's cheated and he betrayed me. So you knew he was going to a strip club. I guess the boundaries weren't super clear. And she ends it by saying this, which I think is really fascinating. I'm usually not a jealous person, but how do I move on from this? So it's not even really about the money then?
It's not about the money.
And it's not about the drug use? I feel like there's so much more that we need to know about this.
Why? He's terrible.
Like, going into this, when you hear it for the first time, you're thinking, well, obviously this is going to be the end of their relationship. But she's asking how to move on. She's not like super bothered about the amount of money, it seems like. She's not super worried about the cocaine. It's almost like it must be about the lap. Also, by the way, I just want to get this out of the way. The whole he admitted everything to me.
Stop the cap.
Did he really like go into detail about every bit of this 5 hours? I find that hard to believe.
Yeah.
Here's my conclusion. Here's my main takeaway, okay?
What?
The fact that you're asking on Reddit of all places, and we're just going into these assuming that these are all like real posts. I feel like you're gonna get over it. I feel like if you have if he has enough trust to tell you about all this wacky stuff that he was doing, I feel like in a way maybe you should have enough trust to like get over it. Wow. You're clearly with a guy that's going to tell you when he's up to no good. You're with a guy that clearly must have like stable income. I'm not saying money's everything, but it helps. I feel like you're just looking for somebody to tell you, hey, there's a way over this. There's a way around this. I don't know, man. I just wish I knew like what the occasion was. Like, is this just a normal weekend that got a little bit out of control? I don't know, but it was very nice of him to tell you, you know? I don't know. If you're listening to this, get in touch with me. Like, how do we feel about this? I'll have a link to this post in the description, and you can see if you can find any more information on it. But for me, I'm just like, hey, man, it sounds like he's living a rock star lifestyle, and the fact that you didn't immediately leave him and you aren't super surprised by the money and the drugs means that maybe there's something there that we don't know about. I don't know. It's a mad thing. It's just a mad thing.
So my boyfriend told me yesterday that if he saw or met someone prettier than me, he wouldn't leave me. Then he said there are so many prettier, smarter, richer people in the world, but you have to be content with what you have. It didn't sit well with me, and I felt hurt. He said he didn't mean it like that. Then he said it's just the way it is. Of course there are prettier, better looking women, or women who are sexier. But I chose you, and that's what matters. I've had a knot in my stomach since yesterday. What would you guys do? He is otherwise very sweet and caring and does everything for me and says he cares and loves me a lot. And I can see that. But I find this very hard to digest.
I hate men.
So I think the initial reaction is,
what a jerk. What a terrible guy. What a mean dude.
I think it's much more likely that your boyfriend's actually just an idiot, but there are lots of circumstances where you can end up in a situation like this because your girlfriend, I've had my current partner and previous partners of mine put me in a position because they asked me things like,
what if you found somebody that was so much hotter than me and so much funnier and cooler? Wouldn't you want to leave me for them?
My wife doesn't sound like that, by the way. Let's actually break this down because I really think that this is important. Now, for the record, looking at this post, this guy's 26 years old. I'm 27. He should know better by now, but I guess he doesn't. Sometimes you're going to get all types of fun little questions and quizzes and statements and points that are made by your partner, and they're basically like they're just fun little tests just to make sure that your loyalty is in the right place. You know what? It's actually highly possible that maybe she didn't even put you in a situation like this, and you're just a guy that just doesn't know how to talk to somebody that he claims to love, okay? But it's so easy to just remember the fact that when you're in a monogamous relationship with somebody, your priority when it comes to affirmation and affection should always be them. They should be your number one, regardless of who else is in the universe, whoever your celebrity crush is, whoever you think is the funniest girl you've ever met or ever seen on TV. None of that should matter. All that should matter is the person that you're in a relationship with, unless you're having a conversation about something that completely has nothing to do with you. But it's so easy, whether you're a boy or a girl, or you're a husband or a wife, you're a teenager, you're an adult, it doesn't matter, to just remember who you're talking to and how it's going to affect you long term. I think it actually says a lot about Mr. Boyfriend here that he's willing to say something so outlandish to you to your face, because anybody that knows me and spends a lot of time around me know how much I am talking about how hot my wife is and how cool she is and how easy it is for us to be together and hang out together and live together and be married. So I think it really says a lot about how he probably speaks about you when he's not with you. If he can't even tell you to your face that like you're the best thing that's ever happened to him. Like it's pretty easy. It's pretty easy stuff. But maybe he actually thinks you're kind of lame.
Damn.
The fact that he's willing to admit to you that he's just settling is insane. Like, it's, I don't think it's necessarily mean-spirited. Like, he might actually be really happy to be with you. He might just be dumb. He might be emotionally stunted. Or as Chris Broussard said in the past week,
developmentally disabled.
I'm just truly baffled that this girl really has to sit with the fact that somebody that she thinks loves and cares for told her that there are many, many prettier, smarter, richer people in the world, but you have to be content with what you have. I just don't understand how he thought anything positive could come from that. But just note out there to all you fellas, prompted or otherwise, maybe just don't say that. You know, next time it comes into your mind that there are all of these incredible options, all of these beautiful, rich, incredible, intellectually gifted women out in the world that aren't your girlfriend, maybe just keep that one to yourself. Like, it's really not that hard, I promise you. Now, me personally, I don't have that problem because my wife is the hottest, coolest woman ever. But to all of you others that struggle with that problem where your girl isn't the best in the world, you know, you could always just...
Shut up!
Oh, no, it's over already.
I didn't even know that this episode was going to exist. It's being recorded on a day that I did not expect to have off, so...
Surprise, motherfucker!
If you don't already have Cash App...
Come on, man.
Tap my link in the description. It's the easiest way to send and receive money. You can also customize your own Cash App card and get cash back on qualifying stores. Somebody throw me a real sponsorship. Like, I'm out here doing free promo. Actually, it's not free. If you tap on the link, I'll get a little money. But I'm also trying to help the people out. I would never promote something that I don't believe in. I love you.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
And I mean it. If you're out here listening to therapy episodes unprompted, like, we're kind of friends. I can't promise I'll share my location with you, but... you're pretty cool. All right. Enjoy the outro. I think one of the coolest parts of the show is the fact that I get to share with you some music that, like, I personally enjoy. And I don't know, man. I don't know. I just think that part of the show is cool. What am I doing? All right. Bye.
No calls, no sexing. How could you be so selfish? Selfish, so selfish. Can't help it, I can't help it, I can't help it, I can't help it.